Hi everyone, thanks for joining me today. This is the summit, the Monashee Summit on Highway 6. We're heading west, looks like north on the map here, but west towards the Okanagan from the Kootenays. Now Monashee Mountains is a range that separates the Kootenays and the Okanagan Valley in British Columbia, kind of in the central part of British Columbia, south central, I guess. This road eventually goes towards Vernon, and we'll be heading that direction in the next couple videos. This one we're going to be going to a place called the Gold Panner Campground. It's kind of a marker that a lot of people use when they're referring to this road and they saw something at the spot, or it's one of the few places along here. This is a really neat stretch, really windy, really nice drive through here. This is the beginning of October 2021, so you can see all the trees are changing color and that. This area will get quite a bit of snow, and there is a lot of wildlife in the area. We actually drive past a bear here just in a few minutes. Haven't seen very much. Most of this drive, this is going to be in the kind of before lunch kind of time frame. So in the evenings is where you typically see more of the deer and that sort of thing, more of the animals moving around. Heading towards some rain showers as well, so we'll have a few raindrops occasionally on the lens here. They do wipe them off, but I'll cut that out where you can see. Don't see my hand coming across. You're on the right. It's the bear. Funny thing with bears is you can't really, unless there's something for scale, you can't really tell the size of them, because the small 1 year olds look the same as a, you know, 3 or 4 year old if they were out in an open grassy field or something. The proportions are exactly the same. That one wasn't that big, but when I was driving along here, it's like he was looking right at me. His eyes kind of met. It was kind of funny. I think the water on the right here, I think that's Monashee Pass Creek. I think that's what that is. The odd little spot you can pull off to the side of the road. Don't see too many of them along here, so like there, you could pull over there if you wanted to. There's some wider spots here too. Certainly not a lot of traffic this time of year. I don't know that it's ever really super busy, like even in the height of summer. It would still not be classified as a busy road, so it's a nice route to take. It's really windy, lots to see, and you know, if you head over towards the cusp, there's a couple different routes you could go. You could go north, south, and connect back up around, loop back around, either up north towards Highway Number 1 of Trans-Canada, or you could head down and come back around through the Okanagan again, the Soyuz, loop back around that way, or yeah, there's lots of different little loops. So some people do this in the summer, they just do a lot of drives. Really popular with a lot of people on motorcycles. Mainly for those reasons. Not a lot of traffic and nice wide open roads and windy and not super busy. That's a good pull out there. Yeah, look at the trees, look at all the different colors of green. So I've never spent any time at this Gold Panner Campground, but driven past it lots. They used to do a lot of, coal panning kind of courses and stuff like that there, I think. And there would be a kind of different clubs in that in the province would sometimes have their kind of meetups there and that. Competitions, I guess, for, I don't know, gold panning and stuff like that. I think I remember stuff like that happening there. And it kind of looks a little different than the way I remember it. I think the highway has just gotten a lot better through there than it used to be. But you look at it on the internet, you can see it's quite a big area there. Imagine there must be some history of gold mining there as well in that area. I don't really know of any myself, but probably the case. Here comes the rain. All these tight little windy corners and stuff on this highway kind of get your attention. It's quite steep down to the right there. It drops off quite a ways. little bit of blue sky ahead, so that's a good sign. Getting close to it here. It's going to be on the right hand side. There's lots of signs warning you're approaching it, that sort of thing. So there it is there. And this is where we'll end this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this kind of thing, think about subscribing. Always appreciate it if you give it a like. And other than that, I'll catch you on the next one.